Today, I visit with Kevin and Rochelle Nelson, better known as Sonshine Road. It's a duo. I'm Rick Jay, and this is Spotlight on the Arts. Well, welcome to Spotlight on the Arts. I ask you if you please would join me in welcoming Sonshine Road, Kevin and Rochelle Nelson. It's good to have you here, Rochelle and Kevin.
Great. Well, thank you so much for having us.
Yes, I'm truly excited to turn the spotlight on you today. I've grown to love your music and your message in the music. And a bit of your story, as we've been friends for quite a while now.
Yeah, so, it's been a few years, yeah.
Yes, I tell you. So, well, if you would, please tell us a little bit, take a turn there and tell us a little bit about Kevin and Rochelle. If you anything you want to share personally, I know if you've got grandchildren that you share and spend time with, and
it's
like you're the perfect couple.
But how did we meet? You know, we met actually in a nursing home
where I was not a resident. But
oh, I see.
I used to be in my mother's gospel band, and she booked us at a nursing home in Cameron, Missouri, where she worked.
Oh, yeah. I see.
I was singing in my mom's gospel band because she thought that that would help my Christian walk. I had just gotten out of prison in 2011, and I'd gotten out of prison a Christian. And so she thought she could help me in my prison walk in a way that I liked music, then it would help me out. So we would sing at nursing homes and churches. In the gospel band my mom was in, called Citizen Band, as in Jesus, we're all citizens of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
But she called her up. I mean, it's kind of her story there.
She did. So there was this lady on the phone, and she had this gruffy voice, and she says, "This is Jackie Shields of Citizen Band, and we would love to come and sing for your residents." And I had this tiny, tiny budget. And I said, "How much?" And she said, "Honey, it's not about that. It's about coming there and loving on your residents and reminding them that Jesus loves them and just, you know, making their spirits lighter." And so it was awesome. It was on a Thursday night. It was in 7 o'clock at night. And it was, when I say awesome, I also got to meet a long lost cousin of mine, which was the band leader. I mean, God's fingerprints are all over this thing.
Yes, I'm seeing that. I'm feeling that. I think somebody was made this happen.
Yes.
So we have to give it to the higher power sometimes. You get those blessings, and you're guided, and all of a sudden, boom, how I met you folks, you know.
Yep.
With the Apple Festival, with the Jimmy Jack Whitaker being part of that Lonesome Road industry ministries. So I always feel that I'm guided, yes, and you're part of that, and we'll talk about a little bit about the traveling. So, well, Rochelle, so you just all of a sudden you felt it, huh, that this might be a good relationship, a partnership, companionship?
No, I wasn't looking. No.
Well, you wasn't. No,
when God told me that, that Kevin was ready for me, I fought him tooth and nail.
So I was going to say, did you fight that a little bit?
A lot.
Well, with my criminal history, prison history, drug history, alcoholism history, her experiences with that and other men never turned out well.
And abuse.
But by the time that we got together, I mean, that was my past. I mean, I was walking with Christ.
Right.
He made a new creature out of But preconceived notions and everything, and my mom told her exactly.
The very first day, and that's my son Kevin, and he's been to prison not once but twice, and he was an alcoholic and a drug addict, and it was just like, hey.
I don't want a part of that.
Right.
But I guess he must have done the walk and not the talk, but done the walk and convince you. Sometimes you do have to go to task and we have to prove ourselves to people. So.
Yes, but it wasn't a matter of her trying to get to know me any better or anything like that. Because of the band, Citizen Band, and her long lost cousin being the leader of that band, she really liked listening to us sing at her nursing home. So she started coming to other nursing homes that we were going to just to listen to us.
Oh, super.
And then she would be in the back of the room singing along with us as we were singing, at the front. And my mom just finally said, "Shelly, you need to come up here and get behind this microphone." So she
That
got
was my.
shanghaied into the band.
Yes.
And then we were in the same band for a year before we ever started dating.
Oh, I see. Good. I'm glad you give us this. Because people think, well, how does this thing, something like this comes together that sounds so good and it's from the heart, and you can tell there's more to it than just two people standing. So that was my next question. How did it come together? Finally, you said, I think I'd like to be a part of this. So that's how you really became a part of it, singing, Rochelle?
No, I wasn't even asked.
Now, had you sung before
Her
in a
cousin
group?
just brought her up and said, "This is the newest member of our band." He just made her a band member without even asking her.
At the nursing home when I was working.
Oh, so all of a sudden, boom, huh?
Yes,
Well,
sir.
great. I'm sure glad you made that decision. You walked up to that stage and became part of it, and all your voices just blend so well.
It's
It's
definitely a
almost
God thing.
unbelievable, how well they blend. So, well, we give it to him again, and thank you all. Actually, you had to work together to get things, I'm sure, sorted out. I've been in relationships, but it looks like it's really a great relationship. So, thanks for sharing that with us.
Well,
That's a lovely
it helps
story.
very much to keep Christ centered in our
Oh,
relationship.
yes, I think that's what people forget to do.
Equally
If
yoked.
you're, they have to, that will keep you centered. If you're getting out of line, you're going to know it. You'll
Yeah.
see at
Well, and
some
that's
point.
just one of the things about Kevin and myself in our marriage is that if it seems like I'm going away, if I'm acting a certain way, or if he is, then we make sure to talk to each other and in love and respect and say,
Yes.
maybe that wasn't the thing to say, or maybe did you think about that before you did
Or
it, or
like one of her
great. So
favorites,
you,
iron
iron
sharpens
sharpens
iron.
iron. Yes, iron sharpens iron. So I've got a good feel of, I call it faith, not a religion, but a faith.
A
You don't walk in the
relationship.
faith.
Yes.
You can walk in religion and be lost. You see a lot of that. You
Yeah.
walk in the
The
faith,
Bible's full of
you've
that
made
with the
a.
Pharisees and Sadducees and
Oh, yeah.
Yes, so exactly. So you walk in the faith, you're committed.
Amen.
Okay,
Yes,
great.
but
Well,
so
thank you for
people
sharing
started
that.
inviting us out to their churches in order to for me to share my testimony about my prison time and my
Yes.
addictions. And I needed somebody to sing with me because to give a good testimony on a service, rather than just stand up and talk for 5 minutes, we would do a whole service and we would
Oh, I
incorporate
see.
music around testimonies, and Rochelle started sharing her testimony, which is completely different than mine, but every bit is impactful.
Exactly.
So our music fed our ministry, and our ministry fed our music, I guess you could say.
Exactly. Yes. I think that's, well, I know my personal background, Vietnam and all that. If I hadn't had that, I don't have anything really to feel complete about. Because I know I've, like many people, you have your issues that you still maybe deal with, but it's always someone that I discuss with, but I give the trust and the guidance to the one. Well, Less we've talked about your music and how great it is, how it reaches people. So I'd like to run one of those songs now, real quick before we go to break. What would you like to share? Which song would you like to share with the world that probably.
One of them, we have a video. We made a video of it's a transition video, and it's my testimony song, but it's something that it doesn't exactly show my transition, but I'm representing the transition of a lot of people. Alcohol abuse is so widespread. Drug abuse is
Yes.
so widespread. The only thing that fixed me was Jesus.
Amen.
And becoming a child of God. And this here video, which is when I didn't have a prayer, it shows me down in the bottom, rock
Huh?
bottom. It shows two people trying to witness to me and invite me to church. My wife in the video, which is Rochelle, that didn't work very well.
No.
And then a little girl that plays our granddaughter. And our
I see.
granddaughter witnessed to me, invited me to church a completely different way, and that got to me. And then it shows my transition of cleaning up and then going to church,
Yep.
and then coming back into the fold. But
Super.
it to me, that's a message of don't give up on somebody. And there's
Amen.
not necessarily a right way to witness to somebody. Some people will take that in your face kind of a witness, but some people you got to be gentle with them. And the Lord will
Yes.
show you how to witness to particular individuals. That
Right.
doesn't mean we won't misinterpret and do it the wrong way, but then God can send somebody
Looking for
else.
that guidance again, it sounds like.
Exactly, exactly.
Well, let's run that selection. And give it the name again one more time.
When I didn't have a prayer.
Do you think he'll listen to you this time?
Just pray, baby girl. Pray.
You're back again. I can take care of myself. I've been doing it for a long time.
We love you and we want to see you in heaven with us.
Did you bring Bree with you?
Yes.
Are you trying to bring her to help manipulate me into church?
No, she loves her papa. Are we supposed to give up on you? Won't you come to church with us, please?
It just ain't gonna happen. You need to go on back home.
Keep praying, baby girl.
Wait.
Dear Papa,
We've all been praying for you. All you're doing is killing yourself, and it's killing us too. Papa, please come to church. We all miss you, and I love you so, so much. Papa, please, please come to church.
I turned away God's love, not a prayer to Him above. I believed that by myself I'd find my way. Though I often let Him down, He believed I'd come around. He knew that I'd be needing Him someday. He loved me when I didn't have a prayer. And when hard times overcame me, He was there. Even through my stubborn pride, He was right there by my side. He loved me when I didn't have a prayer. I was slow to see His proof, though I hungered for the truth. And my steps were weary on that lonesome road. I felt hopeless, lost and shamed, when He softly called my name and led this broken black sheep to the fold. Oh, He loved me when I didn't have a prayer. And when hard times overcame me, He was there. And with all my stubborn pride, He was right there by my side. He loved me when I didn't have a prayer. When I was too blind to see, His love watched over me. He loved me when I didn't have a prayer.
Great, Rachel. That was great. Y'all sound so great.
It's reaching
people with your music.
I
understand you have another member of the group with you. Can you introduce this person?
I sure can. This
Hello.
One here, he's a full-time job as well. His name is Ozark Nelson.
Well, at Ozark? 90 years old, Ozark Nelson.
Oh, I see.
Kinfolk, uh-huh. To coast. And this past year, no, this past 4 years, I've been running for P resident of this here United States.
Oh.
We need to get the Holy Ghost into the White House.
Oh, I
but
see.
You
well,
know what?
Ozark, can you hold a minute? We've got to go to break, and then we're going to hear more from you. So hang in with us if you can. We'll be back and learn more from Ozark Nelson there. Okay, great. Thank you. Hang with me, everybody. There's a lot more here on Spotlight on the Arts. I'll say, okay, welcome back, everyone. Let's turn back to Sunshine Road, Kevin and Rochelle, and the other member of the group, Ozark Nelson. Well, Rachel, I guess you've introduced Ozark. Ozark, really, what part do you play in this group or duo?
Well, since I didn't get me no electoral votes this past November, now I'm a pre-voter for Jesus, so I be pre-voting these sunshine peoples, going all over, letting people know there's the Holy Ghost out there, and letting them know how to react. But, yep, that's me. I'm the one that goes to telling people about the sunshine people.
Oh, excellent, excellent. So you kind of keep things in line? And make
oh,
sure.
Oh yeah, somebody's got to keep
you got to make sure
rain on them, Pete.
Got to make sure they hit those notes, right?
Well, that's right. That's
you probably
right.
Do a little of the.
You know, they well, don't never ask me how to sing.
Well, you all travel a lot. Do you do some of the driving?
Well.
Or do you sleep in the back seat?
Oh, I do a lot of the sleeping. Yes, sir. I'm telling you what.
I kind of figured that.
Long drives take it out of me.
I see. Well, you travel. Can you tell us about some of your travels recently and then where you're headed next?
Well, I'll tell you what. We went to the big city a while back, Pigeon Forge, Tennessee. And I saw things I just couldn't believe. Why, they was the biggest monkey I ever saw climbing up the side of a building.
Oh,
and
my.
They had a house built completely upside down.
Yeah.
And then there was a fishing boat right there, a great big fishing boat right there on the side of the road. And there weren't no place to fish.
No.
I don't know what they was doing.
But I'm telling you what,
you get to doing some traveling, you see some things, wondrous things, and there just ain't no telling what you're going to find once you get east of the Mississippi River. Been down to Louisiana, found out about Boudin. Oh, that is the best tasting sausage I ain't never seen in my life.
My.
You ever had the Boudin?
Well, you've been to Nashville, and you just the last few months, you guys have been all over the place.
That's right.
Yeah.
Where are you headed next?
Busy.
Before we run out of time, where are you headed next?
Well, we're home for a while. We got to sing some New Year's Eve stuff.
Yep, at our home church, Calvary Christian Union Church in Excelsior Springs, Missouri.
Now, you've been to Branson.
We just
recently.
Was at the Branson last week, a few days ago, yeah?
Yeah.
So people can find you at Branson and all over. Just look for basically, how do we get a hold of you? People get a hold of you so we can find out where you're going to be appearing next, Ozark.
Yep. I'm pretty sure your pigeon ain't going to find a way, so carrier pigeons out the question. But we do got us a website. It's a Sunshine Road. Wait a minute. It's www.sunshineroad.com.
That's S-O-N.
Yes, ma'am, I'm telling you that. S-O-N, as in Jesus
S-O-N.
Christ is the
yes,
Son of
sun.
God.
Sunshine.
Gotta
oh,
put
super,
the O
super.
In. If you say it like the big orange ball in the sky, it ain't going to come up.
The wonderful thing about our website is that our Facebook page, Sunshine Road is incorporated into it.
Yes, it
Oh,
is.
it's linked together, incorporated. Right. Well,
That's
now
right.
also, I have you, your music, Sunshine Road, on the GMN TV that we've recently just contracted on Roku. So we've got
Yes.
a lot of your selections there. And I have a link that you folks can buy their CDs on Rick J's Marketplace. So there'll be a link on every their performance. I think we've have eight of your performances on GMN TV Plus. I'll give you that link at the very end so you can look up that. So yeah, we're kind of really got things going here, and hoping people buy and share on your from your website and also from your links on GMN TV Plus. Well, I'd like to run one more song. I think you have a song
That's right.
on the
Your
charts.
Lord come to me in a dream a while back, showed me a little bit about what heaven's gonna be like. So we got a
Uh-huh.
little song about that.
Oh,
It's
super.
called the Denture Song.
The denture song.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Is that with or without dentures?
Well,
Kind of both.
it might tell
Kind of
you a little
both.
bit in the song
Well,
about it.
we'll have to see what that's all about. Well, okay,
Anyway.
let's take a listen to that, and then let's go ahead and turn to that then.
Ozark, he can't chew like he used to.
No more apples.
Do tell.
I went to draw water the other day and dropped my teeth in the well.
There'll be no dentures in heaven. There'll be no polygrip there. We'll sing and we'll shout. Our teeth won't fall out.
There'll be no more cups by our bed.
Church last Sunday.
I prayed to the Lord for some teeth.
I heard this woman did shout.
Her teeth then fell out and landed at my feet.
I answered prayers.
There'll be no dentures in heaven. There'll be no polygraph there. We'll sing and we'll shout. Our teeth won't fall out.
There'll be no more cups by our bed. Someday. When I get to heaven and see the beautiful sights, I'll be full of cheer, grinning ear to ear, showing off my pearly white.
Yeah. There'll be no dentures in heaven. No polygraph there. We'll sing and we'll shout. Our teeth won't fall out.
There'll be no more cups by our bed.
Hey, Ozark, will you have hair?
You certainly will.
What about, will you be able to hear me?
Say what?
Ozark, will you be able to see?
Of course. But
there'll be no dentures in heaven. There'll be no polygraph there.
Only ghost to go.
We'll sing and we'll shout. Our teeth won't fall out.
There'll be no more cups by our beds.
We'll sing and we'll shout.
Our teeth won't fall out.
There'll be no more cups by our bed.
Well, that was great from Ozark, Nelson. I see Kevin, Rochelle back with us again. That's quite
Thanks
a gentleman you
me.
Have around. I guess he keeps you inspired. So,
he keeps us on our toes, I'll tell you.
Yeah.
Well, I want to thank you all for contributing to Spotlight on the Arts. I know you're affiliated with the Lonesome Road Ministries, which we also have a lot of different programs, testimonies, what have you, from Gary, the head chapel, shall we say, Lonesome Road Studios. And you all represent that group as you do travel, correct?
Yes, we do.
Yep.
Yes, we do. They put out so many CDs that of messages. And we get boxes of them, and we take them everywhere we go and leave them at churches and leave them at festivals. And you know, it just helps spread the word.
Yep.
And it's a great message. It's not like some of the groups or foundations trying to get it out. It seems like it's more humanistic. It's for truck drivers and anybody else that really wants to hear some good music. Including you all, and also the testimonies and the messages that are sent out. It's really a complete. That's why I look forward, you know, I basically begged them to kind of help me out on the GMN TV, Rick J. Presents and Spotlight on the Yard. So,
well, like they like to say, it's a whosoever ministry, and we're all whosoever.
Whosoever, yes.
Amen.
Yes. Well, thank you once again for inspiring us and giving us all this information and sharing your message and your songs with us. So thank you both. If you have any closing words, go ahead. We've got about 3 minutes.
Well, we are also affiliated with the Jimmy Jack Foundation, which is a foundation started by Jimmy Jack Whitaker. It helps kids reach their musical dreams.
Yeah.
There's a lot of kids out there, you know, that just can't afford musical instruments. Yes. And Jimmy Jack goes around and he collects instruments all over the country. And then people can call him up and say what they need. He'll check them out to make sure it's a reliable source. And yeah. And he hands out instruments. And in the first or the second Saturday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday of December every year, he has a foundation.
The second weekend.
It's the second weekend of every December. Yeah.
On, yes. Uh-huh. Branson, Missouri.
Foundation banquet. And we're going to miss it this year, but this is the first time we'll miss it. But it is an awesome time. And that's actually how we met you was at the Apple Festival in Versailles. Yes. And yep. Jimmy Jack was
well,
there.
I interviewed Jimmy Jack and can't thank
and Danny O'Neill.
Danielle O'Neill, and I've interviewed them. That is on GMN TV Plus, along with your oral. So
I was watching.
Now going out
I tune into your TV show.
Thank you. Thank you. So they can learn. I've also promoted the upcoming event to raise funds. So that's on GMN too. Well, once again, I got about 30 seconds. So I want to thank you again. And I want to thank you viewers for watching. Don't forget to check out my Spotlight on the Arts on the new GMN Plus TV streaming network. Rick J saying, stay healthy and safe. See you next time.
But we do have right. We have the New Year's Eve sing that was my idea to start
three years ago.
And uh-huh. So we have other artists that come in. Greg McDougall's going to be coming in. Steve Bruno Samuels is coming back in. Oh, we've got Carrie Bates. Donna Kilmurry usually is here. She's not able to make it this year. We MC it, all the lineup and everything. That's my baby. And then the church
great.
Does
and
the
where's
taco
that going
bar.
To be held? Where will that be held?
At our church, Calvary Christian Union.
In Excelsior Springs, yeah.
In Excelsior Springs, okay.